Hey guys, it's Jenny. Welcome back to my channel. Today I'm going to be doing a review on the Render No Show Through Paper by Crescent Creative Products. I bought the sketchbook myself and I got it from Gordon Harris. I actually recorded me opening it and all that exciting stuff, but I have no idea where the files went. They just disappeared, so never mind that. I will say that this paper is great for lining. Like, if I had really steady hands, I would absolutely love this paper to do really great line work with, but unfortunately for me, I have extremely shaky hands, as you can see when I do my line work. But if you are good at lining, you'd probably really like this paper. The thing that bugs me about the cover, like, it feels really nice quality, but as you can see with the light from my lights, like, it shows up every single finger mark, like every single finger mark, and that bugs me so much. Like, I'm gonna be constantly wiping this down. But apart from that, like, it's really nice. Like, the quality is good and you get quite a lot of sheets. You get 96 pages, so like 48 sheets. I bought this for, it was on sale. I think I got it for about $40, that's in New Zealand dollars. I got it from Gordon Harris while it was on sale. Normally I think it's about $55. You can get it from Amazon for probably cheaper, but I didn't want to wait for the shipping, and paying the shipping costs for me isn't usually worth it unless I'm buying like quite a few things. The paper was really nice to sketch on, like, it's nice and smooth. When you use like a marker or paint or something wet on this paper, it shows through the like a gray tone and it doesn't look nice with color. Like, it fades away as it dries, you'll be able to see that, but as you're coloring, like, it kind of puts you off a bit about what shades you're using and what colors you should use, because it just looks completely different to your actual color. But when it dries, like, it looks great. But it did really throw me off when I first started coloring, because I did do a Copic sketch marker drawing before this one. I really didn't like how it came out, so I didn't really show it, but I decided to do a watercolor afterwards to test that as well. But the Copics did show a lot of gray through the paper as they were wet. Then as they dry, like, it looks good, but that's just something to think about. Like, it does throw you off. So you'll see there's like a grey undertone to the paint, like, it doesn't look good, but it does dry and look better. But it is, really didn't like that about it. Apart from that, like, the paper is great, I loved it. It does hold a lot of paint quite well, like, layers and layers. I end up adding quite a few, and it does hold it really well once it's dried, and the color does look nice once it's dried as well. It's quite shiny as I'm working on it, so when I use this like metallic paint later on, it looks really good. but it does show up quite a lot of the brush marks, I noticed, like a lot more than like a nice firm matte normal watercolor paper. It just depends what your preference is. I did like how you can use layers and layers and the paper doesn't buckle that much and it doesn't bleed through, obviously, which is the main point of this paper. The sketchbook did come with like a slight wave through the entire paper, but I don't think that was Gordon Harris's fault. I think that's just what the paper does, like it's got a wave through it. Glittery paint, and it does show up like a lot of street marks more than it did on just normal watercolor paper, which is a little bit frustrating, but like it still looks good. It's just I don't like the streaks. I tried not to go overboard with the glitter, it was just so satisfying to put it down and like look how good it looks in the water. This is the finished product. I think it came out really good considering it's in a sketchbook and I normally work on really thick paper, Like, I really don't like buckling. And yeah, it came out pretty good. Like, it's really streaky in the light, but from further away, you can't really tell. Anyways, I hope you enjoyed this video and subscribe if you want to, and I will see you in the next one.